Good morning, students. In today's session, I am going to discuss about exception handling in C++. And in today's session, we are going to discuss about what do you mean by exception, what are the different types of exceptions, what are the different statements we are going to use in exceptions, and how we are going to handle the exceptions in C++, and what do you mean by user-defined exceptions. All those things we are going to discuss in today's session, right? Before going to start exception handling, here just I will recall what do you mean by error. Here, what do you mean by error? Here, error, there are different types of errors are present in C++. Syntax error, semantic error, logical error, all those things are going to be, all those things are known as the error. For example, how the error is going to generate. For example, see here, I am going to print here world, right? Just I want to print world. Here in this case, here I am not going to put any semicolon here. Right? Then I am going to try to execute this program. Just I want to print the world. Then what will happen? It will show the error. Right? It will show the error. What type of error is there? This is the syntax error. Right? This is the syntax error. Right here, whenever we are going to compile any program, at the compilation time only, here the compiler is going to recognize what type of error is going to be generated. We have to rectify that particular error. By seeing the statement, we can easily rectify that particular error if any error is going to be generated in our daily programs, right? Here, syntax error is there, logical errors are there. For example, I want to perform C equals to A plus B. In that particular case, just instead of plus, I am going to put minus. At that time, what will happen? Here, logic is going to be missed, logical errors are there. Here, semantics errors are there. Various types of errors are there. Those are here. Whenever we are going to compile this program, at that time, we can recognize that particular error and we have to rectify that particular error. Then only we are going to get our output. Right here, but here exceptions means runtime errors. Exceptions means runtime errors. Exceptions are run here. Exception also the errors only. For example, see here. I want to print the division of two numbers here. Just I am going to write int a equals to 5, b equals to 0, c, right? C equals to a divided by b, c out. Just I want to print the value of c. Now whenever I am going to try to execute this program, here what is the value of a equals to 5, b equals to 0, c, put the semicolon. We are putting the semicolon, so the statement is right. Compiler is going to read the statement. This is the syntactically it is right. Next is c equals to a divided b, syntactically it is right. C out, just we are printing the value of c, syntactically it is right. Now here whenever it is going to execute this program, run this program, what will happen? Here c equals to a, what is the value of a? 5. What is the value of b? 0. 5 divided by 0, what is the value of this 5 divided by 0? This is infinity, right? Here in this case infinity is there. So here system is not going to execute this program, and system is not going to give any answer for this one. Syntactically these statements are right, but system is unable to produce the error. Such type of errors are known as the exceptions. These errors are runtime errors. Whenever we are going to execute any program, we are not going to get the proper output, right? Syntactically those statements are right, but we are unable to execute that particular program, we are unable to get the answer. Right, such type of errors are going to be exceptions. Such type of errors are known as the exceptions. Here we don't know what type of exceptions are going to be generated. In our program. So here, to avoid such type of things, we are going to use exception handling mechanism. Exception handling mechanism is there. An exception is a problem that arises during the execution of the program. Exceptions are generated whenever we are going to execute any program. At that time only exceptions are going to be generated. Here, exception provide a way to transfer control from one part of the program to another part of the program. Here, whenever any exception is generated, just we have to transfer the control of that particular program from one block to another block. From one block to another block, just we are going to transferring the control of that particular program. Just we are going to transferring the control of that particular program. Here, whenever the exception is generated, just we are going to throw that particular exception and we are going to catch that particular exception. Whatever here, what type of exception is going to be generated, depending upon that particular exception, we are going to throw that particular exception, right? Here, that's the reason the compiler is going to transfer the control. The compiler is going to transfer the control of that particular program from one part to another part whenever the exception is going to be generated. Here in C++, exception handling is we are going to handle the exception by using three keywords. First one is the try, catch, and throw. Yes, here we are going to use three keywords: try, catch, and throw. Here by using these three keywords, we are going to handle the exceptions, whatever the exceptions are generated in our program. Here, try, catch, and throw. Here, in try block, here, we are going to write any code, here, user is going to think that maybe exception is going to be generated. Maybe. Here, we are not going to, surely we can't say that that particular exception is going to generate it. If we know that exception is generated, then what is the need of that particular writing in try block, right? Just directly we can avoid this one. For example, see here exception is going to generate b equals to 0. Here user knows that the exception is going to generate. In that particular case, instead of writing 0, I'm going to put 2. Then here I'm going to put 2. So no, here user, if the user know the exception is going to generate, then no need of that particular code is going to written in the try block. Here generally, here if you are going to write a big program, or if you are going to develop any project, in that particular project user, here the programmer doesn't know what type of flaws is going to come, right? What type of error is going to be generated. Here he doesn't know what is the flow of that particular program. In that case, here user is going to think that here maybe in some cases exceptions are going to generate, some undefined errors are going to be generated at that time. Here for our security purpose, we are going to use that code, we are going to putting that particular code in the try block, right? Whenever here a try block identify a block of code for which particular exceptions will be activated. It is followed by one or more catch blocks. Whenever we are going to put any code in the try block, here we have to write the catch block for that particular exceptions. We have to write the catch block for those particular exceptions. For example, I am going to write the code for divide by 0 exception is there. Here user, here in my program I am performing division operation. Here whenever I am going to performing division operation, in some cases here that a divided b, their b value is going to be set to 0. In that particular case, here user knows that here this type of error, this type of exception may be generated. So at that time, you after try block, user is going to write about the catch block. Here if you are going to write any try block, we have to write the catch block only. A single try block is having multiple number of catch blocks also. Here in a single block of code, multiple number of exceptions are going to generate. Whenever any exception is going to generate, that particular exception is going to be catched by the catch block. In some cases, some undefined exceptions are going to generated. Those undefined exceptions are not going to handled by the catch block. Here if the user know what type of exception is going to generate, at the time only he is going to defining that particular exception in catch block. If user doesn't know that what type of exception is generated, then that particular exception is not going to handled by the catch block. right? Next, throw. Here, a program throws an exception when the problem shows up. This is done using the throw keyword. Here, we can throw the exception. What type of exception is going to generate in the try block? We can throw the that particular exception by using the throw statement. Here, we are going to use the throw keyword. By using this keyword, we are going to throwing that particular exception. Whenever we are going to throw any exception, that particular exception is going to catch by the catch block. Right? Here again, I repeat, here in exception handling there are three types of blocks we are going to use. One is try, catch and throw. Here in try back, we are going to put a block of code. In that particular block of code, we are going to write a code. In that particular code, may or may not be exceptions are going to generate. If any exceptions are going to generate, here that particular exceptions are going to throw to the catch block. Catch block is going to catches that particular exception and it is going to execute that particular exception. Single try block is having multiple number of catch blocks in some cases, right? Assuming a block will arise an exception, a method catches an exception using a combination of try and catch keywords. Already I explained here, by using the try and catch keywords, we are going to handle the exceptions. Right? A try and catch block is placed around the code that might generate an exception. Code within the try catch block refer to a protected code. Whenever we are going to write any code in that particular try and catch block, that particular code must be in protected access specifier mode. Already you know that there are three types of access specifiers are there. Here public, private and protected are there. Whenever you are going to write any code which is present in the try and catch block, that particular code must be present in protected format only. See here, general example. See here, the syntax for try and catch block. See here, try. Here I am going to write the protected block here. For this single code here, we are having maybe three types of catch block. Three types of exceptions are going to generate here. N is there. So for a single try block, we can have n number of catch blocks. We can list down multiple catch statement to catch different types of exceptions in case your try block arises more than one exception in different situation. Here, depending upon the situations, exceptions are going to generate. Here, we are having multiple lines of code is going to present in the try block. Whatever at that time, multiple number of exceptions are going to generate. Then those exceptions are going to handled by the catch block. Here, for a single try block, we can have n number of catch statements for a single try block, right? Yeah. The code which is present in the try block must be in the protected code, right? Yeah. Then why we are going to use this exception handling mechanism? First is here, separation of error handling code from the normal code. Here, whenever we are going to write any code, here user knows that in this part of this program, some case exceptions are going to generate or errors are going to generate. So that type of code user recognize that type of code and user is going to put that type of code in the try block. So by using that one, here user is going to avoiding the errors. Here in traditional methods, here there are always if else condition is there, right? By using the if else condition, here it is going to handle the errors in traditional method, right? First, if this condition is true, we are going to execute some block A. If the condition is false, we are going to execute some block B, right? Here, block A, block B is there. So in traditional methods, we are going to use the if else method. Now to handle the various types of errors here, in some cases in classes we are going to in classes errors are going to generate, or else in objects errors are going to generate. Here in that case we are going to use this exception handling mechanism. Here this conditions and the code to handle the error get mixed up with the normal flow. This makes the code less readable and maintainable. With try and catch block, the code for error handling becomes separate from the normal flow. Separate the normal code and error handling code. Right, this is the first case. That's the reason we are going to use the exception handling mechanism. Second one, functions or methods can handle any exceptions they choose. Here, what do you mean by function? Function is a subprogram which is used to perform a specific task. Here, whenever we are going to performing a specific task, in that particular case, any exceptions are going to generate, any errors are going to generate. Here, those errors going to handled by that particular functions only if any error is going to generate in that particular function. Right, here no need to search for the entire program, just we have to go through that particular function and we have to check any error is there in that particular function. That's it. If any error is there, then we are going to rectify that particular error. So it is very easy to handle the exceptions which are present in the functions. Why? Because function is a block of code. If we are going to put any functions in the try block, then easily we can recognize that particular errors and easily we can rectify that particular error. If any error is going to generate in the function, then by using the exception handling mechanism, just we have to put the complete function in the try and catch block. In the try block, if we are going to write the complete function in the try block, if any error is generated at that time, that particular exception or that particular error is going to be handled by the catch block. Right, here function can throw many exceptions. Single function can throw many exceptions, but may choose to handle some of them. Here it is depending upon the function only whether that particular exception is going to be handled by the particular function or not. It is going to be dependent by the particular function only. The other exceptions which are thrown but not catch caught by the handle by the caller. If the caller chooses not to catch them, then the exceptions are handled by the caller of the caller. Here if any exception is going to generate, that particular exception is not going to handle by the catch block, then here general exception handler is there. That particular exception handler is going to handle that exception which is generated in the function block, which is generated in the try block. Here if user want to handle that particular exception, then he is going to write the code in the catch block. In the catch block, that particular exception is going to be generated. In C++, functions can specify the exceptions, that is the throw, using the throw keyword. The caller of this function must handle the exception in some way, either by specifying it again or catching it. By using the catch block, he is going to handle that particular exception. Third one, here grouping of error types. How that particular grouping of errors are going to be processed in C++. Here generally we are having both basic types and objects can be thrown as exceptions, right? Here basic data types are there, objects are there. Here in C++ we are going to use the objects. If any error is generated in the object, then we have to throw that particular object. If any error, if any exception is generated in basic data type, we have to throw that particular basic data type exception also. Then we can create a hierarchy of exception objects and group the exceptions in namespaces or classes or categorize them according to the types. Here we are using the namespaces. Here because of that namespaces, we can group that particular exception in a single group. We can group that particular exceptions. Here, for example, in my program, diagram, there are 4 to 5 same type of exceptions are generated. In function 1, same type of exception is generated. In function 2, same type of exception is generated. In function 3, same type of exception is going to generate. In that particular same, at the same, in 3 functions, same type of exceptions are generated. Again, if we are going to put in that particular block in try block, every time we have to write its catch block. So to avoid such type of thing, we are going to grouping that particular exceptions. Grouping is possible in C++ only. So that's the reason we are going, by using the namespaces, we are going to group that particular exceptions, and we are going to place in the namespace. Just by using that, just we have to call that particular namespace, and we can handle that particular exception by using the namespaces or classes. We can categorize and we can place all those similar exception in a single class. Also, we have to use that particular class to handle that particular exception. Right? These are the why we have to handle this exceptions. Means first one is separation of error handling code from the normal code. Second one is the functions can handle any exceptions any by their choice. Grouping of error types. That's the reason we have to use this exception handling mechanism in C++. Now, next, moving to the next topic here, throwing the exceptions. Whenever any exception is generated, that particular exception is going to throw in the try block. By using the throw statement. Exception can be thrown anywhere within the code block using the throw statement. Here, throw is the keyword to throw that particular exception. This is the keyword, right? By using this keyword, we are going to throw the exception. That particular exception is going to be generated in that particular try block. Here, divided by 0. This is the general example you already learn in C also. This is the generalized example. If it any divided by 0 means it is going to give the answer infinity. Infinity is not present in the computer. That's the reason exception is going to generate. This is the general concept, right? Here, for example, see here, double division int a comma b. Two variables I am defining. If b equals to 0, throw divide division by 0 condition. Here error is generated. If b equals to 0, exception is going to generate. Or else if b is not equals to 0, then we are going to write return a by b. You see here, for example, in this example here, I am going to write a equals to 10, b equals to 20. In that particular case, double division int a comma int b, a equals to 10, b equals to 20. So here b, what is the value of b? B value is 20. 20 double equals to 20. Condition is true or false? Condition is false. So throw division by 0 condition. Here 20 double equals to 20. Condition is true. Condition is false. So go to the return part. Return what value? Here we are going to return 10 by 20 value. 10 by 20 value is 0.5 value. So 0.5, here I am defining double value. So that's the reason 0.5 answer is 0.5. But whereas in this case, if I am going to write a equals to 10, b equals to 0, then here it will check the condition. If b double equals to 0, what is the value of b? B is 0. 0 double equals to 0. Condition is true. So it will throw the division by 0 condition. It is throw the exception. Here by using the throw keyword, division by 0 condition is going to be thrown. Division by 0 condition is going to be thrown by using this throw keyword. Here generally, what is the use of this throw keyword? Exceptions can be thrown anywhere within a code or block using the throw statement. Here already we throw the exception. Whenever we are going to throw the exception, that particular exception is going to catch by the catch statement. The catch block following the try block catches any exception. Whenever here we are going to putting this code in the try block, right? If any exception is going to generate, we are going to throw that particular exception by using the throw keyword. Throw the exception, that particular exception is going to catch by the catch block. that catch by the catch block, and you can, we have to specify what type of exceptions you want to catch, and this is determined by the exception declaration that appears in parenthesis following the keyword catch. Right here, whenever we are going to use any catch block, we must know what type of exception is going to generate and what type of exception is going to caught by that particular catch block. Right here, see here, for example, here try protected code is there. Here, whatever the code we are going to write, it must be in protected code which is present in the try block, catch, exception name and a e. Here we have to, in catch block, you have to specify the name of the exception. You have to specify the name of the exception, exception e, code handle the exception name, exception, right? Yeah, above our code will catch an exception of exception name type. Right, to specify that catch block should handle any type of exception that is thrown in a try block, just put in a place between the parentheses and close the exception declaration as follows. Here we can catch multiple number of statements, we can catch multiple number of exceptions by using the multiple number of catch blocks. Right here, up to here, exception handling mechanism is consisting of three statements: try, catch, and try catch and throw keyword. Right, see here, I'll show one example here. Division by zero exception, how we are going to catch that particular exception. Hash include iostream dot h, iostream using namespace is there, int main, right, int main. Here int a equals to 20, b equals to 10, c equals to 10 is there, right? Int a equals to 20, b here int a equals to 20, b equals to 10, c equals to 10 is there. Now I am going to perform division by 0. I am going to perform division by 0. How I am going to perform division by 0? See here, just I want to first here C out before the exception. See here, I am writing one code that is C out before the exception. Every time C out before the exception statement is going to be generated. If B double equals to 0, if B double equals to 0, just we have to throw the B. If B double equals to 0, just we have to throw B. If B is not equals to 0, then we have to perform C equals to A divided by B. C equals to A divided by B. Now in catch statement, C out divide by 0 here. Here what is there? Yes, we are throwing the value B. Here in catch block, divide by 0 statement is there. Divide by 0 is there. Right? C out after the exception, C value. C value. What is the C value here? Here C is 10 is there. Here, now here we are performing the value here. I am going to execute this program. How I am going to execute this program? Check this one. A equals to 0, B equals to 10, C equals to 10. Here, what is my output here? For example, my output is, I'll write here output, my output. Here, C out before the exception. So, it will print this statement first before exception, right? It will print the line and L, go to the new line. Try B equals to 0. What is my B value? B value is 10. 10 double equals to 0. Condition is true, condition is false. So we are not going to throw the value of B. So C equals to A divided by B. What is the value of C? A value is 20. A value is 20. B value is 10. Now 20 divided by 10, C value is 2. Now my C value is 2. Here any exception is not generated, so there is no execution of catch block. C out after exception C. So my output is C after exception, right? After exception. Here, what is the value of here? C value. What is my C value? C value is 2. So my output is before exception, then after exception 2. See here, before exception, after exception 2. For example, if my value is, see here, my A value is 20, B equals to 0, C equals to 10. See here, instead of 10, just I am going to put here 0. b equals to 0, a equals to 0, b equals to 0, c equals to 10. Now just I want to execute this program. How here first it is compiler is going to read this statement, a equals to 20, b equals to 10, b equals to 0, c equals to 10, c out before the exception, right? First it will write this statement. What is my output here? First compiler is going to write this one, c out before the exception, before exception, right? It will print this statement. Next, try if, what is the value of b? B, my value is 0. If 0 double equals to 0, 0 double equals to 0, what is my condition? Condition is true. If this condition is true, throw this one, throw b directly here. Whenever throw b means, just here control is going to transfer to the catch block. Whenever we are going to throw, statement is going to execute, control is going to transfer to the catch block. What is my here? Here it is going to write this divide by 0, divide by 0. What is my output here? Divide by 0, divide by 0, right? Catch block is executed. After the catch block, what is the next statement? C out after exception. So every C out exception, every C out statement is going to generate execute now. So after, what is the statement? After exception, after exception, right? After exception. Here, what is the value of c? What is the value of c? Here we are not going to process this one. C equals to a divided by b. Here the statement is not executed. That's the reason. What is the value of c here? We are not going to change anything. So here, what is my c value? C value is 10 only. This is my output. If I am going to write b equals to 0. If I am going to write b equals to 0. Now I am going to execute in Dev C++ software. So I'm going to write hash include IOStream, hash include IOStream. Next one is, and here using namespace std, using namespace std, right? Int main void, and int main void, open the braces, open int a equals to 20, b equals to 10, c equals to 10, right? C equals to 10, put this semicolon, c out before exception, before exception end. Right now I'm going to write in try block, try if b double equals to 0, if b double equals to 0, what will I have to print here? Throw b, right? Throw b, t, sorry, throw b. We have to throw b, or else c equals to a divided by b. C equals to a divided by b, right? Next, here try block is completed. After try block, we have to write the catch block. Catch, right? In catch block, just I'm going to write here catch c out. C out divide by 0, divide by 0 exception, divide by 0 exception, right? Here this is present in catch block, right? Put the catch block is completed. Then here I am going to write C out after exception, after exception c value is and c. Yeah, just I'm going to put here end l. I'm going to put here end l. Right, now I'm going to try here closing this first. Close the main already. I'm close the main. So here I'm exeq. Just I'm going to save this program. Now I want to try to execute this program, compiling the programs. Is there any errors are there? Here errors are zero, warnings are zero. Then just we have to run this program. Now what type of output I am going to get here? Before exception, after the exception, c value is 2, right? Before exception, after the exception, c value is 2. See here, right? Before exception, after the exception, just I didn't write here c equals to 2 na, just value of c is 2, right? Same output is generated, right? Now just I want to change the value of b here. Save this program. Now error is going to be generated. A equals to 0, b equals to 10, 0, a equals to 20, b equals to 0 is there na. Exception is going to generate, divide by 0, exception is there. Compile the program. Any errors are there? So errors are 0, warnings are 0. Then run the program. Yeah. What type of output? See here, divide by 0 exception. Before the exception, then divide by 0 exception. After the exception, c value is 10. Check this one. Already I explained now. See here, output before exception, divide by 0. After exception, c value is 10. See here. Before exception, divide by 0, exception, after exception, c equals to value of c is 10, right? Up to here clear, how we are going to handle the exceptions, right? How we are going to handle the exceptions when any exception is going to generate. By using the try and catch block, we are going to handle the particular exception if the exception is going to generate. These are the user-defined exceptions, right? Here. Now, here what are the, here. What are the various types of standard exceptions which are present in C++? Here C++ provides a list of standard exceptions defined in exception class which we can use in our program, right? These are the arranged in parent child class hierarchy shown below. Here in exceptions we are going to use the inheritance concept. In inheritance concept only we are having the child class and the parent class. See here. This is the basic class. In standard exception class is there. This is the main parent class is there. In this parent class is having various types of different types of exceptions are there. These are exceptions are present in a single class, that is the exception class, right? See, exception, standard exception class is there. Standard bad alloc is there, bad cast is there, bad type is there, bad exception is there, logic failure is there, runtime error is there. Again, runtime error is going to give overflow error, range error, underflow error. These are the subclasses of runtime error class. Here domain error is there, invalid arrangement argument is there, length error and out of range. These are the subclasses of the logic failure exceptions. Here all these exceptions are going to present in the exception class. Again, exception class is having its child classes alloc, cast, typeid, exception, logic failure, runtime error. Again, runtime error is going to divide it into three classes, three child classes. errors. Here in that particular case, overflow error is there, range error is there, underflow error is there. Here in this case, domain error, invalid argument, length error, out of range error, all those things are going to be present in the logic failure exception class, right? Yeah. See here, in yesterday exception, an exception and parent class of all standard C++ exceptions are present in standard exception class. Whereas in standard bad alloc class, this can be thrown by a new keyword. Here alloc, kelloc and malloc. What is the use of kelloc and malloc operators? By using the kelloc function, we are going to calling the memory. By using the malloc function, we are going to allocating the memory. Memory allocation is going to done by new keyword. That's the reason it is going to thrown by the new keyword. Here bad cast is there. In this case, here this type of exceptions are going to thrown by the dynamic cast keyword. Dynamic cast keyword, by using this dynamic cast keyword, here we are going to thrown the this type of error. Bad exception is there. This is useful device to handle the unexpected exceptions in a C++ program. Whenever any unexpected exception is going to generate, in that time here bad exception class is going to handle such type of exceptions, right? Next one is the bad type ID is there. Here this type of exceptions are going to thrown by the type ID keyword. This type of exceptions are going to thrown by the type ID keyword. Now is the logical error. Logical error, whenever any logical error exception is going to generate here, that type of exception is going to handle by the logic error class. Here an exception that theoretically can be deleted by reading that particular code. Any logical exception is going to generate means we have to delete that particular code from our project, from our program, right? Domain error is there. In that particular case, this is an exception thrown when the mathematically invalid domain is going to be used. If you are going to perform any mathematical operations, in that particular case, this type of error is going to be generated. This type of exception is going to generate. So in that particular case, just we have to throw in the mathematically invalid domain we have to use, and we have to throw in that type of exception. Next one is the invalid argument. In this case here, this is thrown due to the invalid argument. Here for example, I am going to pass the in a function call, I am going to pass the integer arguments, integer parameters int a comma int b. Now I am going to try to pass float or double value or character value. In that particular case, those are the invalid arguments are they, that's the reason exceptions are going to generate. So that type of exceptions are handled by the invalid argument class. Next one is the length error. This is thrown when too big string is going to be created. Here whenever we are going to declare any string, we have to define the range of that particular string. Within that particular string range only we have to create that particular string. If for example I am creating one string, I am declaring the string length is 20, means we have to use 20 characters only. If I am going to use any 30 to 40 characters to construct a string, in that particular case length error class is going to generated. Those exceptions are going to be handled by the length error class, right? Next one is the out of range. This can be thrown by the at method. For example, a standard vector and bit set operator. Here this is the out of range class is going to handle by this at keyword. Next one is the runtime error. Runtime error class is there. An exception that theoretically can't be deleted by the reading the code. Here code is right, everything is right, but here exception is going to generate. That type of exceptions are going to handle by the runtime error class. Next one is the overflow error. This is thrown if the mathematical overflow is going to occur. Here that type of exceptions are going to handle by the overflow error. That type of exceptions are going to handle by the overflow error. Next one is the range error. In that particular range error occurred when you try to store a value which is out of range. If we are going to try to store the value out of range, then range error exception is going to be generated. These type of exceptions are going to handled by the range error class. This is the parent class for that type of exceptions. Right. Next one is the underflow error. Here this is thrown if the mathematical underflow is occur. If any mathematical underflow is there, if we are going to use any mathematical operations, in that particular case here mathematical underflow error is generated. So that type of exceptions are going to handle by the underflow error class. here. Now all these are the standard errors, standard exceptions are there. These standard exceptions are present in the C++ library. Whenever such type of exceptions are going to generated, directly those exceptions are going to handled by the C++ library. If new type of exceptions are generated, user can define its own exceptions. Right here, those exceptions are known as the defined. User can define its new exceptions. You can define your own exceptions by inheriting and overriding exception class functionality. Here we have to use the concept of inheritance and overriding. Method overriding is there. Method override, already you know that what you mean by overloading and overriding. So here we are going to use the method overriding concept. By using this method overriding concept, we can generate our new exceptions. See, following the example which shows the how can use standard exception class to implement your own exceptions in standard way. Here in my example, I am going to use standard exception class. By using the standard exception class, I am going to handle the exception. I am going to defining my new exception. See here, using namespace struct. Here I am creating one my new exception, that is my exception is my exception, public exception is there. Now constant character, what constant throw here, here whenever this type of exception is generated, so constant flow, whenever here this type of error is going to generate, exception is going to generate, it will return the C++ exception. Right. Next is int main here. Try in try block here, throw my exception here. I am going to try this exception. Throw my exception is there. What is my exception here? See here. My exception is C++ exception. This is my exception. Directly here it will execute the block of code. Right? Here whenever any exception is going to throw, that particular exception is going to catch by this one standard output my exception caught here. Exception which is created in try block, that is going to handle by this caught block. Here e dot what is going to be generated, catch the exception and other errors. If any other errors are there, those are going to be catch by this catch block. But here my own catch block is there. Here this is the my own catch block. In this my own catch block, I am going to executing this one, right? Yeah. What is my output here? My exception caught C++ exception. See here, this here. Whenever I am going to throw this exception, directly control is going to transfer here, and here what type of exception is going to generate here. First my exception caught is there, then it is going to print that what we are returning here, C++ exception is there. So C++ exception is going to be written here. In this example, what is a public method provided by the exception class and it has been overridden by all the child exception classes. This returns the class of an exception. Here already what class is present in my exception, just we are going to overridden that particular my exception class in our program. Now I am going to execute this program in my in Dev C++ software. See here, no need to create this one, just we have to control C, new source file, control V. Again here we have to include the exception class, right? Include exception, right? Now here we have to use using namespace std. Next is struct my exception, in public mode, exception in public mode, exception is open the braces, in this case constant char space. Here what type, here we are going to use the what method, char star what method, right, what constant throw. Constant throw and opening the braces, return C++ exception. Just we are returning the C++ exception. Up to here I am defining my new exception. Up to here I am defining my new exception in which here every structure is going to end with its semicolon. Every structure is going to end with the semicolon, right? Now I am going to write the function int main void, open the braces, here in try block. I am going to write the code in try block, throw my, what is here? Control C, my exception, right? Control C, my exception, and put the semicolon, right? Delete. Catch block is completed. Try batch is completed. Then we have to write this catch statement. Catch again, control V, my exception ampersand E. Here my exception is generated. So I am going to use that one. Here I am going to catch this one, opening the braces, std, right? Here stand, already this std is there. Here also see here, every time we are using this std, right? We are using this std na, that's the reason. Here also we have to write this std c out for this one. C out what type of my exception is caught, right? And std and l and l and new line. Here next is std c out. Here e dot, here what function is there now? Here what we have to call that particular what by using this here exception e is there. Exception e object is created. By using this e object only we are going to call the what method, which is present in that particular try block, right? E, right, std and l, std and l, right? Up to here one catch block is there. Here if any other errors are there, I am going to use different catch blocks. Catch std here for exception address of e. If any errors are there in that particular case, I am going to use this one, right? And open the braces, that is just I am going to write other errors. For the other errors, if any errors are there, those are going to handle by this catch block. Here I am not going to defining any catch block here, just completed catch block. Then after completing the catch block, we have to put the closing of main. Okay, right. Then I am going to save my program. Saving this program. Right. Save. Now try to execute this one. Is there any errors are there? Compile. We have to compile now. Is there any errors are there? Errors are zero and warnings are zero. Now executing this program. What type of error? What type of output we are going to generate here? See here, my exception is caught. That is C++ exception. My exception is C++. So I am going to return my exception class. I have written the override the my exception class. Here my own exception is C++ exception, right? Here with this exception topic is completed. In today's session I completed here what do you mean by exceptions, what are the different types of exceptions are there here, and how we are going to use the exceptions. All those things I discuss in this session, right? In next session we are going to start our second unit. With this first unit is completed, right? Thank you.